Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. In the previous tutorial, we have now created a new URL and a view. We've connected them together, and we can now view the output on our web page. So let's now turn our focus to creating a new HTML template, because ideally we want to send web pages back to the browser, not just text. Just reviewing our diagram that we utilized to explain the Django request response cycle, hopefully you can start to see this come together now, in that we start the Django server. So we have a server running to capture the request. We then have our Django app, which will then inspect the data that we send, the HTTP request from the browser, inspect the URL, and make a match with a number of our URL files that we've created. When the match is made, we have seen that within our URL, we connect a URL to a view. So we've seen that, and we've seen so far that we can build a HTTP response and send that directly back to the browser. So now what we're going to do is to build a new template. So we're going to build a HTTP template. We're going to tell the view that we want to use that template and send it back to the browser so that when the user does type in the resource, matches the URL, it's going to now send back the template and not the text like we previously learned how to send. Django does automatically look for certain destinations or folders for templates. So what we can do here without changing any of these settings, we can create a new folder inside of our new app here and call this templates. So Django will inspect this folder and look for templates that we've specified within our view so that it can return and serve it back to the user. So what we can do inside of this templates folder is create a new file here called, let's call this index. That's typically the first page or the name of the first page of our website. And now we can go ahead and create some HTML. Now, I'm just going to create some simple tags here for our HTML page. The text will go inside the body tags. Hello world, there we go. So now we've built our template, and you can make this more elaborate if you're familiar with HTML, of course. Let's now move over to the next tutorial, where we'll go ahead and connect our template to a view so that we can serve it to the user.